Hello and welcome to the third explainer by Argumenta podcast. So this is going to be a very short explainer. So basically stay tuned to it. I'll be joined by Ryan James and he's going to be talking about what ambush marketing is. So stay tuned and do check out the video.
So Ryan, since you're talking about endorsements and you're talking about how teams actually market themselves as the next big thing, or even companies as well, how they market with their products as such, how do you define the entire marketing system currently, with especially since you have also dealt with the terms like ambush marketing as well? What really is ambush marketing, and also what is something which comes along with it into the system as such?
The ambush marketing is like, it's a strategy of marketing. It's one of the, obviously there are a lot of marketing strategies. Ambush marketing is one that is used. It's a very cheeky way. So now in terms of marketing, when it comes to sports, it's very big. You all know it, you know, it's there in every aspect. You have your geo advertisements. It's very big. I don't have to talk to you about it because you guys would have seen it. So I think if I talk about ambush marketing, it'll be a little more interesting. So how ambush marketing works is today, Vivo is the sponsor of IPL. We know that it's Vivo IPL. And let's take a competitor of Vivo's, Xiaomi. So let's say today IPL match is going on. It's happening in the stadium. There's full crowd. So now what Xiaomi will do is Xiaomi will send all of their, they will send a bunch of people. They'll send 20 people to go watch that match. And those 20 people will be wearing a Xiaomi t-shirt. Okay, so now in that match, what happens is now while the camera guy is showing the audience, he might deliberately end up showing the bunch of people wearing the same t-shirt, and they're all wearing Xiaomi t-shirts. So now what's happened is Vivo is the one who's paid money to endorse themselves for the entire IPL. And now Xiaomi is not even paid one bit of money, and they've gone inside the stadium and they are getting endorsed because they're shown in TV for that 1 second. And this happens, like, I think even once a footballer where he was, I might be wrong in terms of the brand. So I think let's say Adidas was the sponsor of the entire tournament. This guy was a athlete of Nike. So what he was doing is before the match started, because he was a star player, he just was tying his shoelace and they were obviously showing him. So when the camera turned towards him, they saw him tying the shoelace and he was tying the shoe, the Nike shoe. So Nike got endorsed when they did not pay any amount of money. So that is a brilliant marketing strategy. And in sports, it's done properly from the Olympics all the way to any sport. It's done properly when it comes to sports. And other brands also use it in other aspects, such as fashion or HR or whatever. They use it there as well.
So basically, since how does the entire mechanism work? Like, is the cameraman already told about certain aspects about where to shoot? Like, basically, you go give a quick phone call to the camera, to all the cameras to come and focus on it, because you already have a pre-existing sponsor on the boards or every part of a stadium. So how does that capture the eye of the viewer, and also how is it also legal or ethical, if you could talk about it?
See, today it's well controlled. Okay, today everyone knows it's a strategy. So when I was working with BFC also, my job was actually, if anyone, so we had a list of the sponsors who are in regard with the event. And if anyone walks in wearing a t-shirt with that, we have to tell them you wear it upside down or we won't let you in.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so we do that. And yeah, but once again, now you don't have to go inside a stadium to do it. Okay, from this. So I think once what Budweiser, I think, or Carlsberg, the beer brand. So in one of the Euros, if I'm not wrong, I might be wrong, in one of the tournaments, they were a different kind of sponsor. Okay, they were the, you know, happiness sponsor. You have different type of happiness sponsor, or, you know, media sponsor and stuff. So they were a sponsor for a particular aspect. And there was another brand which sponsorship deal was to just give out free things. Okay. Now what Carlsberg did is they also ended up going and giving free items. So now when it was the platform was for the other brand to give it free items and get that recognition. But Carlsberg also did that out of their contract. Their contract didn't involve giving free things. Mm-hmm. But they also gave free things. So they also ambushed the market here. That's also ambush marketing. So I'll tell you another instance. In the 2012 Olympics, if I'm not wrong, I'm not sure, I might be wrong again. Philips was a sponsor, the electronic sponsor. And what Beats did is they came up with a new headphones called Beats by Dre or something. And they, so now let's say I'm an athlete there, I'm representing India. They gave every athlete a headphones with the flag. So what those athletes did is they ended up going for Olympics wearing those because it had their country's flags. So Beats again didn't pay any amount of money, but these athletes went in wearing their headphones, which they got for free. And all the people ended up, obviously, you look at the athletes, you look at what they're wearing, you look at this. So they don't particularly, but in terms of legality, there have been a lot of cases, but you know, it's, they prove it, you know, because see, they've done nothing wrong. All they did is, you know, let's say this became a case. They did nothing wrong. They gave it to the athlete, you know, and the athlete just wore it and went inside the thing. So there is, they don't have any grounds to sue them.
No, but like, since I asked about legality, like we do have, for example, Dream 11 was the sponsor for IPL, but you also had some players, like don't want to name them, but then they had sponsored, they had been the sponsor, yeah. Like their sponsor was MPL or I think there's one Star or something. So isn't that anti-competitive or isn't that actually going against the entire, like it's pretty much illegal if you could say so? How is it considered?
See, that wouldn't, that is obviously, that would come. It's called, it's a usual conflict of interest. So before the contracts are signed, okay, like even once again, even Ronaldo is a Nike athlete, but he wears Juventus, which is Adidas. So what happens here is, I had the same doubt. I asked a few lawyers and they told that whenever a contract is made between the club and the player, there is a, in the contract, obviously all these matters are taken into place and they lay it down accordingly, stating that this player is a brand ambassador of this and only for the duration of the match, they will be wearing, they will be endorsing the team thing. Because you don't have a choice here, you know, it has to be, the conflict of interest cannot happen.
No, but because since Dream 11 was the sponsor, you also had like Sourav Ganguly, who's the president of the BCCI, said he was endorsing Dream Circle, if I'm not wrong. So there again, like pretty my much, laptop. Yeah, my laptop. Like,
correct. So that is once again,
and pretty much you are conducting the entire IPL as well as that. So how does like how like, I think they were okay with it. The companies were okay with that as such. And how far will it go in the future as such? Like
see,
you mentioned,
like I said, you know, they ensure like today that is a very big legal issue, and that's why it is taken care of. So now, if Ronaldo's case can be taken care of, I think anybody's can. Now, at the same time, you know, it's on the discretion of the athletes. You know, I think once Michael Jordan was forced to wear the jacket in one of the Olympic Games. And he didn't want to endorse. And what he did is he just put the American flag covering that logo.
Okay.
Huh. So I'm saying all these, there are a lot of strategies in regard with this. You know, they will obviously, because it has to be taken into consideration. Now, Sourav Ganguly can't step down from being a BCCI president just to endorse My 11 Circle. And My 11 Circle won't miss out on a chance to endorse, I mean, to get Sourav Ganguly as a person. So, like I said, they have it written down. Whenever they sign a contract, they'll be like, you know, Sourav Ganguly would have said that, listen, I'm part of IPL. When I will be in the, when they showcase me on TV, they will, I will be there with along with Dream 11's banners or whatever, but it is, although that conflict of interest is going to be declared null and void. So yeah, that's how it is dealt with.
But are there any laws in India? If I'm not wrong, I think the max to max we only have is like Trademark Act or Copyright Act as such. And those are with respect to, if it's misrepresentation of certain goods as well. And then with regard to this ambush marketing or similar kind of laws, how is there anything in India? And also, is there anything abroad as well with your information?
I'm not sure about abroad. See, but like I said, you know, ambush marketing is something where your existing laws only can apply. Because see, you're not doing anything wrong, typically. Think of it.
Okay.
No one's doing anything wrong. Even, let's say Ronaldo's tying his shoelace. He's tying his shoelace. You can't. They can't make a case out of it. There's no proof that someone told, hey, Ronaldo, you have to tie your shoelace. He can't like, and he can't not tie his shoelace just because he's a Nike thing and Nike will get endorsed. So in India also, I'm saying you can't make a conflict out of it.
Mm-hmm. So it's going to be pretty much regularized or normalized in the coming days to come. Or is it still looked down?
Ambush marketing is already normalized. It's a strategy. That's why if it is a marketing strategy out there. So In terms of it being normalized, yeah, it's being normalized. People are, they are learning new ways to you know, defend it. So I think once there's that one ad where, you know, Pepsi, I think something Pepsi was with the, a Pepsi can with, I forgot the, this thing, you know, where Pepsi actually made fun of Coke through something. There's a meme, it's their own thing. And Coke replied to it, you know, immediately saying that, you know, all heroes wear capes. I don't remember. I think a lot of you would have seen it on Instagram. So they do have ways of coming back. But ambush marketing has become, you know, companies literally hire people just for ambush marketing. So,
like, especially during, like, what particular period of time will people actually see it? Especially, is it especially during the strategic timeouts or particular to shots of the stadium at large, or where is it usually?
It can be anything. See, I told you the free incident in one of the Olympics. I think Reebok was the sponsor, if I'm not wrong. And what Nike did is they literally, so there's this main stadium. Okay.
Hmm.
Nike literally built an Olympic Games village, which is not opposite, but let's say you have to go straight and take a right to go to the stadium. In this road where you're going straight, there is a Nike Olympics Games village that Nike built.
Mm-hmm.
So now they just built it out of their thing. Okay. They built it because they wanted to. Now, while I'm traveling to go to the Olympics, my idea is to go to the Olympics, which Reebok is paid to sponsor. So I'm traveling, going to the Olympics, but I end up seeing Nike.
Hmm.
Okay. So that's another instance of Nike ambushing the event here. That is, once again, ambush marketing.
But also,
so Nike is...
I
was saying, so Nike, even though they built that village for purposes, their target was the people going to watch the Olympics, and they ended up getting attention from the people going to watch the Olympics, whereas they didn't pay a bit amount of money for the Olympics also.
Just the last thing, okay? Like, this is not regarding sports, but similar to marketing as such. This Netflix and Prime, how they tweet or they put their tweets into it. Example, like Manoj Bajpayee finished Family Man in Prime, and then next he goes to do a series in Netflix. So I think the Prime tells, "Shikan job badalne mein utna time nahi lagana." Like it's actually a very it's a dialogue in Family Man, and that Prime had replied to Netflix's announcement of the series. So is that also a method of ambush marketing, as basically like, is it just simply a friendly banter as such, or is it actually a marketing strategy similar to this, or it's different?
See, it depends. Once again, it can be a marketing strategy. If you know, recently also in the Kings 11 Punjab guy tweeted saying something about RCB, you know, thank you for KL Rahul and Chris Gayle. And then again the RCB guy replied saying you've copied our this thing and all of that.
Uh-huh.
So I don't know if that is, see, it can be a marketing strategy sometimes. Okay. It's like, I'll be honest, this is what I believe. Not because I'm a LeBron James fan. There are these two sports takers known as Skip Bayless and Stephen A. Smith. Okay. Mm-hmm. Those two guys, I feel the amount of, they get a lot of attention every time LeBron James. Now, because LeBron James is like one of the biggest athletes and he gets all the attention, when you say something bad about LeBron James, everyone looks at you like, what? Okay. Or let's say you're the popular guy in college and all of a sudden a random guy out of nowhere makes fun of you.
Hmm.
He disses you properly. He roasts you. Everyone's going to look at him.
Hmm.
So just like that, a lot of companies use this as a strategy to steal limelight of that. So even if Netflix uses the word Shrikant, they are stealing limelight of Amazon Prime's show, basically. Because Shrikant is referring to Family Man.
Mm-hmm. So it's not,
and you can't do anything about it. It's written down facts that they use.
Uh-huh. Fair enough.